On intro, we talk about waterfront property. That's what it is, waterfront property. Luke is buying up the property, check it out. It's gonna be worth a fortune one day. So yeah, there's a lot of attention going on there now. Be careful, be very careful in the city of what we might get involved with. It's a great opportunity for some and not for others.
Actually, the Water Management District owns the property. I lived in College Park. I lived on the water. I do know that when they came, they took away a lot of my property to build a seawall there. So we have to listen to Water Management. I think it is a good idea for the people that own boats west of the area to be able to bring their boats. It's not going to be a massive boat that they're going to bring over. It's not going to be a huge increase of boats that are going to impact people's lives. So I am in favor of that. I do know we have an advisory board, and I'm sure that I would love to talk with them and see their ideas, but it's not up to the city. It's up to the Water Management District in Palm Beach County. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. This is our last question for the evening. We'll have a closing statement. We saved the most important question for last, and this is the kind of question that can sway an election in a senior issue. Ellie, who is your favorite Beatle, and why? Your favorite Beatle.
Who is my favorite Beatle?
And why?
It's funny you should bring this up. My dad was in the limousine service in New York City, and we were at Shea Stadium when the Beatles showed up. My father was there, Don Murray, the K, and the boys. I was in the dugout. In the dugout. And the Beatles came by. Talking about mass hysteria. That was all these people screaming. I was 12 years old. I wasn't into the Beatles. But as they walked past me, guess what I did? I grabbed Paul. So yeah, Paul was my favorite Beatle.
Say I love all of them, but the one that I love most is that little red and black one that comes on me for luck. Thank you.
I didn't do any screaming or anything for the Beatles, but I enjoyed the evolution of their music, and probably George Harrison was the most interesting evolution of the
Now, how much time are we allowing for closing statements?
3 minutes.
3 minutes each. Who's going to do closing statements first? Marianne, we're back to you.
Thank you again for holding this. I think it's a great opportunity for everyone to get everybody's view on what each of our issues are. My name's Marianne Flizzy. I'm running for District 4 as your city commissioner. I have lived in the city for 36 years. I have been president of South Palm Park for 2 terms, treasurer before that for 2 terms, and a board director along with the social committee. I did give up the position as president to run for commissioner. I am, however, still on the board, but not as an executive board member. I sat as chairman on the recreation board and in assistant chair on the Sister City Board. I've been extremely active in the city, as well as many different volunteer outfits throughout Palm Beach County, just not in Lake Ward. Volunteerism to me is something that I love with a passion. And I've won many awards, and I'm very grateful for that experience because many people really do need to get out and volunteer and know how much that it helps other people. So I'm very happy with that. I have a history by owning a small business in Lake Worth. I know what businesses need. I have the knowledge, contacts, and education to be a city commissioner to help lead the change that we do need. Everything is fine right now, but we all know that we can tweak something, and I have the ability to get that done. I hope I've convinced you that I'm the right person to be city commissioner. In District 4, Marianne Flizzy. Thank you.
I don't think I'm going to change any votes tonight. I would hope that you all vote for me, but I'm afraid with the turnout, the minds have been made up. But I want to thank, or not thank, but actually appreciate the commitment that my two opponents have made. Doing this is a labor of love. It's also a great commitment that I personally was not the politician that takes to campaign. I think I know that I do have the experience with the activity in the city, with the community, the involvement, and to make the commitment to be your city commissioner. The importance of this job is not just based on friendship or it's something that I'm going to take extremely seriously. I'm my own person as far as politics goes, maybe a little complex, but I think I have the judgment, temperament, and experience to make critical decisions. You have a choice of three, and I would hope that for the love of Lake Worth, you vote for Herman Robinson on March 14th.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, don't confuse. Just don't vote with your heart, vote with your hands. Understand, the biggest issue we have in this city is a financial one. If you don't look at your books and we're not sure what's going on, and we're spending like they are spending, you're only going to get into trouble. Neighborhood association experience does not match political wisdom. We've been down this road, I've been down this road in this city. Palm Beach County was ranked fourth by Forbes magazine as the most corrupt county in America. We will have a problem, we do have a problem, because according to the IG, there are no guidelines set up. And we need to set up those guidelines. That's first and foremost. This is a beautiful city, it will be a beautiful city. Let's keep it a healthy city. My name is Ellie Whitting. I have the political wisdom, knowledge, leadership, because I'm the one willing to talk about these issues and no one else wants to. I'm sure I'm not making a lot of friends. That's okay. Don't vote with your heart, vote with your head. March 14th, go in there and vote for Ellie Whitting. Thank you.